Urbanization is a megatrend which is understudied by not only aid organizations, but even university, academia, and other researchers. Population foci, we will focus on informal urban settlements, which is a global phenomenon as populations are increasing. And also for the riverine communities, they are all part of the urban settlements because as the people are displaced, they migrate into the urban centers and amplify the problems there. So again, we have listed the most critical communities, and these are the justification why we chose them. Burkina Faso, Taptinga is one of the oldest informal settlements in Ouagadougou, and they are very vocal. They also have a lot of challenges when it comes to environment, access to infrastructure, and so on and so forth. In Ghana, we chose Sodom and Gomorrah, one of the biggest, poorest informal settlements, and has brought a lot of challenges between government and civil society and the residents. It's also located in a flood-prone area, and they lack infrastructure, and also susceptible to all the challenges, fire, flooding, open defecation, indiscriminate disposal of waste, and so on and so forth. Niger chose Maraka and Kordo, but I think the emphasis is going to be on Maraka. It has recurrent river flooding problems, and the villages are often challenged by, you know, overflooding, and also their farm asset base get lost during these moments. And so this is one of the reasons why, of course, also contributes to this displacement and relocation or migration. Senegal, Department of Pekin, largest peri-urban community in Dakar. And even though they have very strong personal connections and interpersonal relationship, they call it solidarity. Still, they are also confronted with the normal challenges of informal settlements within the urban milieu. Impacts. We hope the impact on development policy will be immense. It will build an extensive body of research on urban slums, if we examine it through the resilience lens, particularly, that's what we seek to do. And also we're looking at strengthening existing capabilities of the communities we're going to study. Impact for RAND, in terms of the theme, every member country has growing similar problems with urban settlement, informal settlement. And of course, the issue of the rural to urban migration is quite well known by everyone. And when it comes to the impact of the prefecture of Niger, the Maraka, I think the issues of flooding of rural communities are quite well known, and the implications of that. Impact for RAND of examining foci populations. The populations of Taptinga, Sodom and Gomorrah, Pekin are highly similar in many, many ways, and also very, very different when things are not working together properly for them. But even though they are in different countries and in different geographical context. Comparative perspective for identifying underlying resilience capacities that can effectively be strengthened. Examining Maraka, because there are lots of riverine communities in Ghana, in Ethiopia, even in the Sahel countries. All of this can be replicated. The lessons learned from that can be replicated to help strengthen communities in these places.